Hi students, welcome back. Now we are going to discuss some problems on slope of a line. Okay, problem number one, find the slope of a line whose angle of inclination is 60 degree. Solution: given angle of inclination, that is theta, which is equal to 60 degree, we have to find the slope. Slope is m, which is equal to tan theta equals tan 60 degree equals root 3 is the slope of the line whose angle of inclination is 60 degree. If it is 30 degree, then tan 30, that is 1 by root 3. If it is 45 degree, then we can find tan 45, 1, etc. Okay. Find the slope of a line joining two points. Of a line joining points 1, 2 and 5, 7. The slope of a line joining two points. Then they are given two points, one is 1, 2, the another point is 5, 7. This is x1, y1 and will be x2 and y2. Slope of a line joining two points. Given points 1, 2 and 5, 7. Slope m is equal to, the formula is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1, which is equal to 7 minus y2 is 7 minus y1 is 2 divided by x2 is 5 minus 1. We get answer as 5 by 4, which is the slope of a line joining points 1, 2 and 5, 7. Next problem is question number 3. Find the angle of inclination of a line whose slope is, here slope is given, whose slope is 1 by root 3. That is given slope equal to, given slope, slope is m equal to 1 by root 3. You know that slope is tan theta equal to 1 by root 3. Then we can find the angle of inclination theta is equal to, it is 30 degree. Okay, next question number 4. Find the value of k. We have to find the value of k if the slope of the line joining points 2, 5 and K3 is 2. Given slope of line joining, the solution is given that the slope of line joining points 2, 5 and K3 is equal to 2. That implies slope of a line joining two points is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 is equal to 2. That implies minus 2 by k minus 2 is equal to, k minus 2 is equal to 2. We get minus 1 by k minus 2 equals 1. That implies minus 1 is equal to k minus 2. We get minus 1 plus 2 equals k. That is k equals 1. Okay, next question number 5. Find the slope of a line, find the slope of a line parallel to the line joining points, parallel to the line joining points 3, 5 and minus 4, 2. We are going to find the slope of a slope of the required line. This is required line, and a line is parallel to it, passing through 2 points 3, 5, and -4, 2. We are going to find the slope of this line L. If the lines are parallel, then their slopes are equal. Slope of required line is equal to slope of line joining 3, 5, and -4, 2, since they are parallel. Since the lines are parallel, since the lines are parallel, then their slopes are equal. Slope of required line equal to slope of line joining points x1 y1 x2 y2 y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, which is equal to -3 divided by -1. We get 3/7. 3/7 is the slope of the line parallel to the line joining points 3, 5, and -4, 2. Okay, next question, number 6. Lines through the points -2, 6, and 4, 8 is perpendicular to the line through the points 8, 12, and x24. Find the value of x. Given that the line joining 2 points, that is -2, 6, and 4, 8, is perpendicular to a line joining points 8, 12, and x24. Given the two lines are perpendicular, then we have to find the slope of the line joining. First, we find the slope of line joining points -2, 6, and 4, 8, which is equal to slope of a line joining 2 points is y2 minus y1, that is 8 minus 6 divided by 4 minus 2 is 4 plus 2, which is equal to 2 divided by 6. We get answer as 1/3. Let it be M1. Next one is slope of line joining points 8, 12, and x24, that is M2. Let it be M2, which is equal to y2 minus, that is 24 minus 12 divided by x minus 8. We get 12 by x minus 8. Okay, given that the lines are perpendicular, given that the lines are perpendicular, that implies product of their slopes will be equal to -1. That implies then the product of their slopes is M1 is equal to 1/3 and 12 by x minus 8. 1/3 into 12 divided by x minus 8 is equal to -1. That implies we cut 3 into 12, 4 times 4 by x minus 8 equal to -1. That implies 4 equal to minus 1 times x minus 8. We get 4 equals minus x plus h. Then taking x to the left and 4 to the right, x equals, we get x is equal to 4. X is equal to 4. Okay, clear. Okay, we'll discuss some other problems in our next module. Okay, thank you all.